I've been thinking about this podcast a lot, ladies and gentlemen. And one of the things I've been thinking about is I appreciate the fuck out of everybody listening. And we do try our best to make this as interesting as possible and as smooth and professional as possible. But I got to admit that I've been too stressed out about this. I've been taking it too seriously. I mean, taking it seriously in a good way, whereas we improved the sound. We got a real mixer. We got a, I mean, we're sitting on couches and shit, and we're going to get better cameras. But that, like, it's not, like, there's a part of it that's really fun, but there's a part of it that wasn't fun, and I don't think that should exist. I don't think I should ever get too serious about this. This is for people who are working, who are being distracted, that just want something because they're doing mindless shit. This is for people that are driving in their cars and, you know, want something to listen to. This is for people on the train. This is for people at the gym. Whatever the fuck, it's for you guys, all right? And If we take it too seriously, you stop being yourself, and it starts being like this professional thing that you're trying real hard to do. And I think I've fallen prey to that a little bit. I was thinking about it today after I took a little bit of the head of the weed, and I was thinking about it, and I was like, you know what, man, this thing, like, I pay too much attention to it. It should just be a weekly fun thing, like it or not. You know, for anybody who's like-minded, or anybody who's interested in some sort of a distraction from someone who's not like-minded.
Well, knowing you, Joe, you do that a lot on a lot of things.
Everything.
You're obsessed on a
I'm
lot
a
of stuff.
A fucking freak. I got problems.
Like pool.
Yeah, listen, this is my number one problem in life. It's like I try very hard to advance as a human being. I try to evolve. I try to fix whatever issues that I have with myself, whatever errors that I've made in my life. I try to never make them more than once. You know, I try to constantly be moving. But if I have an ongoing theme with problems in my life, the number one thing is with obsessions. I get obsessed with shit. To the point where, like, especially games. But it doesn't have to be games. It could be, we talked about this, it could be beating off. It could be fucking anything. I just get, my head gets super focused on things. And it's good in some ways because it allows you to, like, put a lot of energy into things and work really hard at things. And that can allow you to become successful. I mean, that's the reason why I got successful with martial arts, with comedy, with anything. Because I became obsessed with it. But it's good. If you're like a mindless person, it's good to force you to doing something you're not even sure why you're doing it. You're just doing it and you're getting good at it. You know, you're getting this reward, but you're not really contemplating whether or not you're putting too much energy and effort into one certain thing. You know what I'm talking about? It becomes like, it doesn't become like a conscious thing. It becomes like this is a positive thing. I'm doing this. I'm moving in this direction. It becomes an obsession, and it becomes you just have this need. Like with video games, I had it really bad with Quake. Really bad. I would play 8-10 hours a day, and I would be talking to someone, and if they said a fucking single thing that was boring, I'd be like, why am I even talking to you when I could be playing Quake? That's what I would be thinking. Like, you know, I'd be like hanging out with my chick. We'd be having a conversation about something, and I would be like nodding my head, mm-hmm. And I'm thinking, how much more time do I have to talk to her before I could sneak away and go play Quake?
One of the first times I met you online, we used to play Quake, and there was one time in particular. I don't know if we've talked about this, where we played. I think you killed me 120 times in a row. I hadn't killed you once. And you kept on going, and I was like, I want to stop now. And you're like, no, we must play. Come on. And I'm like, by the way, I'm obsessing about the fleshlight. We should say this at the beginning.
Oh yeah, that's right. We have to thank our sponsor. We have a sponsor. We're sponsored by the fleshlight.
Fleshlight.com, and if you go to Joe Rogan's website and click on his banner on the right side, you get 15% off.
And this
your
is
orders.
How we say it. If you beat off. And I know you do, okay? This is a product that makes beating off way better. It's really that simple. You know, there's a lot of emotional and psychological shit attached to buying a fake pussy that you're actually going to stick your dick in. It's like not a very manly thing. But as you think about money that you spend on and you tell everybody about, like, a new loofah sponge. Dude, I got this fucking sponge. It's on a stick. It's the shit. Fucking get in there. Get all the... You know, I mean, people, like, get all, like, you could talk about pleasurable things as long as it doesn't involve your dick.
That shit changes your life, too. Like, I tried to masturbate with my hand because I was too lazy to bend over and get reach and get the fleshlight that was on the thing behind me. And I tried to masturbate with my hand, and like halfway through, I was like, this is stupid. I need to go get my fleshlight. Like,
it's not nearly as good.
Yeah.
It's because, first of all, you can't enjoy it fully, because no matter how much it feels good to be rubbing on your dick, that's only half of your brain. The other half of your brain is going, oh my God, I have a dick in my hand. and there's a certain amount of your brain that like knows like you are jerking off a dick, even if it's your own dick, even if it feels good. There's some torment there,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
There's some conflict.
I got to show you something, Joe. Something happened to me the other day when I was using it, and I need to warn anybody that has a fleshlight not to do this. This is not your used one, right?
No, that's the butthole.
All right, so like when you pull it out, to clean,
that's like you just like pulled a fish out of a bucket.
Right. It's crazy. So, anyways, when you go to clean it, the end of it, when you don't have this little metal thing in, or the plastic thing in here, hold it up to the camera. There's like a hole that you attach to your faucet. Now I've been like attaching it to my faucet, you know, the water goes through it and blows out the fuck hole. But I've been like holding it like a hose at the end of it, so it fills up with water and shoots the cum out real fast, kind of like, you know, when you do the hose. Well, the problem is I was so stoned when I did it, and I held it and I was facing myself, and it splattered over my face.
No,
I swear to God. Now I don't know if the cum had already popped out because I didn't do it right when
it didn't. You shot your own load in your mug.
So watch out, fleshlight owners. If you clean it that way, you don't aim for the face.
How do you stuff it back in? You just force it back in there.
Push it in there. I don't even know if I'm doing it right because I don't read the directions to anything. But I think you just.
I don't read the directions.